We gotta come back here and buy more stuff. When we have money, because now we're kinda broke. What's this say? South is Ort. Yeah, quite a while south. Right, I talked to them. Yan says, I hear that some dangerous bandits have been appearing in the Tibri Highway up north. I'm sure Phildin will be protected by the King's army, but I sure wish they catch the bandits soon. Malonia says, I heard that the monster that was at the Sheep Highway to the south was defeated by some adventurers. Now we can finally get some fresh vegetables from Ort Village. Yeah, I wonder who those adventurers were. Are these the ones I just talked to? Yeah. Goes off to some other area. Hello? Xiamane says, I'm busy here. Don't talk to me. I wonder where he went. Who's he? Elsie says, welcome. If you're looking for a room, please head upstairs. If you're looking for a meal, please go to the counter in the back. I guess if we go behind the counter, does she say anything? No. Isaac says, adventurers are so dependable. I accompanied some adventurers on the way back from Boren to the capital. A huge monster appeared during the trip, but he defeated the monster with one slash. Bartender says, first time customer, huh? Miles says, how did you know that we'd never been here before? Okay. Well, they were here 3 years ago, but I guess they didn't come in here. I always do my best to remember the faces of my customers. There are other things that I can tell you about you. That I can tell about you. You just started your travels, right? Wow, he's good, says Avin. I can tell because your clothes aren't worn out yet. In any case, welcome to the capital. We're known for our pasta. The sauce that we make out of tomatoes from Ort Village is very popular. And who are you? Jack says, now that we're done with our work, I guess we can take a break. The first drink after work always tastes the best. Improprietor says, it's 20 roses a night. No thanks. Please come again. That's all we have is 20 roses. Someone back there, though. Who might this be? Diana says, it's been a long time since I last visited the capital. The place is bustling with activity as always. It makes me happy. My business will surely do well here. Your business? Avin asks. Miles says, you have a harp. Are you a minstrel? I do play the harp, if that's what you're asking, but I prefer being called a diva. Far away capital Phildin, the town where many dreams gather and come true. Is she singing? Some come here wanting fortune and fame. Others come here looking for unfound love. Yet others come here in search of adventure. Did you come here to find your dreams too? Wow, says Avin. You have a very good voice. Okay, so she was singing. I was mesmerized, says Mile. It's my supreme honor to have your praise. Anyway, don't worry. I won't demand roses from poor audience like you. Avin says, thank you for the break, but your mentioning it made me a little upset. This is Capital Phildin, the town where people win, lose, and get lost in the pursuit of their dreams. I hope you'll find your dreams here. Yeah, she doesn't give a crap that he's offended. Let me out. Oh, God. Oh, that's the way out here. Okay, is there anywhere we haven't been yet? There's a little girl there. And then over here, we've been here, right? What's these people? Yeah. So if we head north... Wow, what's this down here? Oh, we're walking down... Oh, okay. That's pretty cool looking. You can walk completely under here. Wow. Oh, sweet. That's surprising. Oops. Hello. Claude says, a new abbot has been sent in from the holy capital of Valkt. His name is Abbot Zaria, but I just don't feel any authority from him. He's more like a salesperson than a holy man. Okay. Holy man. Oh. Fana says, I saw Princess Mildine at her birthday ceremony. She was elegant and dignified. She is the first princess, all right. Her shining black hair was accentuated by her white dress. She looks so beautiful. Oh, we got a book over there. Avin pulled out a book titled Easy Recipe for Fresh Vegetables 2. Okay, to go along with the book we found in the... whatever cabin, lookout cabin. Do you want to read it? Yes. Fried eggplants. Cut eggplants into round slices and put them in oil. You will need to take the moisture out, or the something. Two, when the eggplant is fried all the way through, take them out right away. That's like cut off there. Or the I can't scroll or anything. Easy recipe for fetched vegetables 3. Fried potato slices. 1. Cut potatoes into thin round slices. 2. Preheat a frying pan, put butter in the pan to melt and fry the potatoes in the melted butter. 3. When the slices are crispy, they are done. Then turn the heat off quickly. 4. Use salt to add flavor if you like. Alright. So we got cookbooks. Oh wow. Well, I wasn't done looking around in here. So we definitely got levels now. So we came from there, right? And then... Oh, there's a guy here. Old Man Laburus says, Milligan the 16th is a splendid person. He suppresses selfish aristocrats and governs well for the commoners. I appreciate that. Yeah. I appreciate that you appreciate that. Wow. We got a bunch of buildings here. Oh, what'd you find? Another rare potion. We're full. Wait. Let's use it on Avin. So we could pick up another one. I can't go behind the counter. I like bothering them like that. Meister says, welcome. Are you here to make a request to the guild? Make a request? Says Avin. Is this some kind of store? This is the Royal Family Approved Adventurer Guild. We handle requests such as monster elimination, mediation, and escorting. If you have a request, we can help. The Adventurer Guild, huh? I've never made a request here. If you have any problems, I'll listen to you. That's what the Adventurer Guild was established for. But of course, we'll ask for payment that is appropriate for the task. Huh. Alright, well I guess we don't have anything to request from you, at least at this time. Hopefully we could handle whatever by ourselves. That goes back. Oh. I don't want to leave the map just yet. I'm trying to go up to this. Church here. Hmm. You sell pet food? Abbot Zaria. Oh, he's the one you were talking about. What do you want? I'm very busy right now. Avin asks, is this place a Bardas church? This is the only Bardas church in the capital. I am the abbot here. I have no time for you. Leave at once. Oh my god. Leave at once. Okay. Well, there's nothing else here, so we will leave at once. I just talked to him. Zucca says, we just moved here. We came from the west, across the ocean. Valkt in the west was huge, but it's not as big as this capital. Hmm. Miles says, hey, that person. On the edge there? Oh, it's Martie. The soldier says, hey, Martie, are you delivering mail to Tibri again? Yeah, it's so true that the poor don't have any spare time. You still with the starving student, huh? I hope you do well with your studies. The soldier says, oh yeah, you probably already know, but the king's army is patrolling the Tibri highway. Be careful so that you're not mistaken for bandits. I know, we have to get going now. Who's we? It's only him. Avin says, wasn't that Martie? I think so. It seems like he's going to Tibri Village. Maybe we should chase after him. That sounds like a good idea, says Avin. I don't want to leave yet. No. The soldier says, hey, where do you think you're going? Miles says, to Tibri Village in the northern forest, and access to the Tibri area is blocked off. They're searching for the Siam Seal Gang. Siam Seal Gang, says Avin. You don't even know the Siam Seal Gang? What isolated village did you come from? Ort? Avin says, sorry that we're country boys. Miles says, we're from Ort Village. Oh, over there, huh? Well, no wonder you don't know them. A gang that calls itself Siam Seal has been showing up in the Phildin area. Investigation showed that their headquarters is in a cavern in the Ziziki Pass to the east. Right now, the king's army is searching the area in teams, so citizens aren't allowed there. Miles says, wait a minute, but that person just headed in that direction. He is an adventurer from the guild. The Adventurer Guild has direct connection with the royal family, so they're allowed to pass through. Avin says, that's not good. We really want to go to the Tibri area. So I'm going to go back to the Adventurer Guild and talk to that guy then, I guess. When will the search end, do you know? It just started, so it's hard to say. If you really want to go to Tibri, you can make a request to the Adventurer Guild. Yep. You can have an adventurer escort you. Avin, what do you want to do? I don't like that idea. It'll cost money, and I don't like to be protected by others. Well, think it over, the soldier says. You're in the capital of the flowers. It's not a bad idea to do some sightseeing. Access is prohibited until the king's army finishes their search. Just relax and hang out. It's closed, I tell you. Hmm. East is Tibri, okay. Alright, so we can't follow Martie, not yet. Miles says, hey, Avin. What? I was thinking, don't you think it's a good idea for us to become adventurers? Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing. I hear that becoming an adventurer will give you freedom to travel wherever you want. At this rate, we won't be able to keep the promise to the old man, and it'll be hard to do the research on Emel's whereabouts. Miles says, remember what Mr. Morty was saying? If we have some skills fighting, we can get certified as adventurers. Avin says, we defeated Hamakages. Maybe we'll be able to become adventurers right away? I don't know about that, but let's go to the Adventurer Guild and find out. Okay, let's also look around more. So we have to leave to... Is this the adventure? Oh, wow. It's like a library. Haha! There's a book entitled Swordswoman Saffy, Volume 1. Is it the same text? Two Swordsmasters. This is the same as in the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. I'm not gonna read it all again. Wow, all the books. Well, if you guys want to pause and read it. Otherwise, I have books up. I mean, I have videos up reading each book. Garnet. I guess here is all the books. Wow. We had to search for them in the Moonlight Witch game. And then when you get all the books, you come across this one NPC who gives you, depending on what you say to him, a choice of swords. I think you end up with Saffy's sword at the end. Yeah. That wasn't a fair fight. Greytown. There's 9 books in all. Rapis says, I'm doing my best to pass the next minister's exam. I can't lose out to my rival. Seven. All named after gems, as you can tell. It's funny because I've done the same thing for my characters in a lot of my playthroughs here. Topaz, Sapphire, Citrine. One more book. Sleeping Girl. Wait, are these the ones I just walked past all these? Yeah. Where's 9? Oh, we have to read that one. Let's just see what this is. The bookshelf is full of books on ores and metals. Avin picked up a book entitled A Miracle Metal, Rare Metal. On occasion, a metal called Rare Metal is discovered from the mines of Guia. Light as a feather and stronger than steel, Rare Metal is a very rare ore, no wonder, that exists in nature only in small amounts. Recent studies revealed its composition, and the discovery has created hopes of its artificial refinement. However, it was not an easy task, given the level of technology available today. Nonetheless, putting this metal to commercial use will certainly bring the industrial technology to a new level. We should monitor the outcomes of research on this important metal. Avin picked up a book entitled Psychology Test. Which profession are you suited for? Are you wondering about which career to choose? Just answer simple questions and this book will tell you the profession you are suited for. Let's start. Oh. Do you put the needs of others before your own? How about always others first? Do you obey rules? I obey rules in general. What do you think of working? Only to earn money. What will you do if you are ordered to fight? I will fight for justice. Merchant. You take some risk for your own benefit. You can make use of the gambler in you by becoming a merchant. Why not believe in your business sense and open a store? Because we're an adventurer. I'm going to check the required book last. The bookshelf is full of children books. Avin picked up a book entitled Mito's Star Badge Part 2. There's Part 1 over here. It is. Mito is lazy. He leaves his toys and clothes everywhere without picking them up. He puts them away only when his mother scolds him. The toys will be angry if left scattered around, she says. Be angry, huh? However, it doesn't stop Mito from creating a mess again. One morning when Mito woke up, his mother said, I am visiting a place afar, so I will be late. Tidy your room after you finish playing. Yes, mother, said Mito. The mother left the house, and Mito was left alone. Great. Mother is gone. I don't have to tidy my room until evening. Immediately, Mito pulled out many toys and began playing with them. He didn't bother to put away his pajamas after taking them off. Balls, blocks, stuffed animals, and picture books. Mito took out all the toys he had and began playing with them. Mito put on his favorite star badge and played. He was so involved in his game, he forgot about the time. It became dark outside, and the light of the setting sun came into the room. Ah? Mito found his star badge was missing. Let me guess, it got angry and ran away. I just had it. Mito looked under the blocks, thinking he might have lost it while playing with them. I can't find it. Maybe I lost it when I took out my stuffed animals. Mito looked under the stuffed animals, but still couldn't find the badge. Continue to part two. Okay. I'll have separate books of me reading these, too. I mean, separate videos of me reading the books. It's funny, I keep referring to my videos as books. Where is it? Mito couldn't find his badge in the closet, either. Looking anxiously, Mito searched all over the room. However, his room was in such a mess that he didn't know where to start. As it got darker outside, Mito felt sad and began crying. My toys were angry with me because I didn't tidy them up. I should have put away the blocks when I took out the balls. I should have put away the picture books when I took out the stuffed animals. He couldn't even find his pajamas. Mito kept crying. Well, even pajamas got mad. And pajamas are normally so chill. What's wrong, Mito? His mother was home. His mother was surprised to see the disorderly room, but soon understand what happened when she saw Mito crying. You lost your toy, didn't you? Yes. You can't find it in the mess, right? Right. Alright, I'll help you. We will look for it as we put away other toys. Mito and his mother began putting away the toys. When it was completely dark outside, they found the star badge hooked on the pajamas. Mito threw his pajamas away to a corner to make room for the blocks. The badge must have been caught by the pajamas at that time. Mito squeezed the badge in his hand and told his mother, Mother, I'm sorry. I'll never leave my toys untidy. The mother nodded with a smile. After cleaning, she cooked Mito's favorite stew for dinner. Mito helped his mother clean the dishes and slept well in his tidy room. A cautionary tale, I guess? So, is this Swordswoman Safi Part 9? Oh, the bookshelf is full of anthologies and of poems. Avin picked up an ancient anthology of poems with a half-torn cover. A tree branch is nodding to winds. It dances in the sky under faint sunlight. The land is blessed with an abundant harvest. Every form of life is singing a song. Their warm sounds are woven finely and delicately. Into a melody of life that glides at the bottom of water, a healing song that is one of its kind. I didn't know you were interested in poems, Avin. Not really. Alright, what's this one? The bookshelf is full of history books. Avin picked up a book entitled An Unofficial History of El Phildin by Waris Meyer. El Phildin is a giant state ruled by the royal Phildin family. In Gagarv 258, the land, comprising the Boreas, Notos, and Dusis regions, were placed under the governance of the royal family. The kingdom has since remained united. Through the periods of division under the rule of the royal family, faith in Bardas has been constant in this land. The religion dates back to the era where people were protected by spirit gods. I describe the current state of this land as one giant state ruled entirely by the royal Phildin family. To tell this land's history, we must first study the history of the Bardas religion instead of the rise and fall of the nation. Many countries have come to power and disappeared, but the Bardas religion has remained an eternal existence in history. You can't talk about the history of El Phildin without talking about its popular culture and faith. The history of El Phildin is the history of the Bardas religion itself. Perhaps this nation, the largest in human history, is still ruled by ancient gods. Wow. Okay. Required reading. So where's that last book? That last Safi book. She's sleeping. She can't tell us where it is. Well, there's another room or something in here. Oh, no, that's it. We're missing the last Safi book. Whoops. Wait a second. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 8. And this is 7. Yeah. Huh. 9 is missing. I mean, I've read it before. But, oh! What happened? Oh, maybe in here. I didn't see that door. It's weird I popped back through, too. There's a book entitled A Drifter's Tale at Southern Sea. We arrived at that sea area in around 3 weeks after leaving Brazac in Southern Dusis. With her mast broken and side lights blown, the ship looked like a long ghost ship. Wind kept blowing and the fog was not likely to lift anytime soon. The hull made squeaking noise and we had difficulty determining our course. There were no replies from the consort ships. They might have been swallowed by the vortex of chaos. The lonesome, desperate sound of a foghorn is sucked deep into the fog. I wasn't interested in this job at first, although it was an order from the king. Gagarv is one of the mystic symbols of the end of the world discovered by Captain Bale. It is the giant cleft lying at the eastern end of the continent. No one has ever seen the other side of it. I was ordered to study Gagar from aboard a ship to find clues that may reveal the edge of the world. Finding the edge of the world is a long-cherished desire of any adventurer and a worthy challenge for me, too. Okay, now these people have an actual excuse for thinking the world is flat. Nowadays, not really. However, the Order was actually an evil plot put together by Count Richard. Not Count Richard, who wants to put me down for good. The sea is unpredictable at this time of the year, and everyone knows that the Vortex of Chaos is raging with fury. I'm not afraid of dying at sea. However, dying by the hands of the court is meaningless. I can't die here. I have nothing to show the glory of my self-made nobility. I have always dreamed of seeing the edge of the world. I have never thought the opportunity would come this way, but I shall swear that I will do my best to uncover the mystery of the Gagarv. Great Bardas, I pray that you will be my guardian. The pages end here. Wow, they really talk about the Gagarv a lot more in this game. It's not really, I don't know what I'm doing. It's not really mentioned a lot in, Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. There's a book entitled Overview of the Spirit God. We've got plenty of reading here. Spirit God Durga is like the mother of humans. The Spirit God, who binds the four great spirits and created this land, is like a symbol of birth and benevolence. However, she is also brings life and death to humans. That's why she is called the Gatekeeper of Hades. She must have been an important figure to the ancient people, who considered life and death to be the same thing. A chapel and a shrine of Durga are left in the Karuna village in northern Boreas, sealed by snow and ice all year round. It is said that Durga and her relatives slept when Bardas, the god of light, and Octum, the god of darkness, were sealed. Many researchers look for clues in the divine object placed in the shrine. A research group at the sorcery school, has been studying Durga. However, so many things still remain a mystery to this day. Is this Safi here? It is. I'll just flip through it quickly. The Sword of Revenge. Silfing, that's the sword you can get if you hand in all the 9 books to this one NPC. Sadly, when we got it, it wasn't... I mean, there was still a sword that Yurio had that was better than Silfing. So we didn't end up having him wield it. That's it. Hello? Professor Logos. I see. So you want to become an adventurer? Then go to the Adventurer Guild. All we have here are books. Why do we ask that about him? Or to him? It's locked. Let me in. But the cat was going to get stuck in there. There's no other door, right? This way that I didn't miss? No. Alright, so that's the library.